We're going to start talking about higher education and possibilities for Mexican students who want to study abroad, in this case at Yale. We have here in Mexico, visiting Mexico, is Linda Lorimer. She's the vice president for Yale University. And Linda, you're in Mexico. Welcome to the show. What are you doing in Mexico?
Well, thank you. I'm here with six of our faculty and 60 of our graduates, and we're trying to have more connections between Mexico and Yale, and particularly see if we can have more outstanding students from the country come our way.
That is great, the fact that you guys are coming down here recruiting people. Could you give a sense as to how many Mexican students go to Yale each year?
Well, we actually have a long tradition. It goes back to the first student that came from Mexico in 1858, and we have students now in residency at our undergraduate college, our management school, and almost all of our professional schools. So we are delighted to be welcoming Mexican students, and we hope to have more.
Now, which of all the different departments, in which department do you think you have more Mexican students?
We actually have had a great number coming to our business school of recent years, but we're hoping in the next few years to have more both for our college and for our PhD programs, because we have expanded dramatically our financial aid programs available to international students.
Oh, that's very important, you know, because I've been talking, I talk to many students. I teach at two or three universities here in Mexico. All of them talk about, you know, their wishes to go study someday abroad, especially in the United States. And because of the devaluation of the Mexican peso, in fact, I know a couple of students who just basically said, you know, I'm just not going to be able to go. We're just simply not going to have enough money. Even if we do receive, you know, the Mexican government has certain aid programs that some students can have access to. I mean, what kind of scholarship, what kind of programs, what kind of aid are we talking about?
Well, I can give some very precise numbers because when Yale celebrated its 300th birthday in 2001, we gave ourselves a birthday present, which was to really try and open up our campus to the world. So for our undergraduate college, if a wonderful young student comes from a family whose parents make less than $60,000 per year, that family pays nothing.
Really?
To have a child come to Yale.
So
it's quite unusual in terms of the extensiveness of this financial aid.
So basically what students have to strive for is to try to get accepted, right?
Precisely. So if we're really looking for the best and the brightest, and if they get accepted, we want to make sure that finances are not an inhibiting factor.
Now, that is really great news. Now, that's for undergraduate. Does that same program apply for graduate work?
Well, let me tell you about that, because it's a different program, and it is also unusual. If you are accepted to any one of our PhD programs, and we have them in over 50 fields, you pay no tuition for any year you are enrolled at Yale, and you get a minimum annual living allowance of over $20,000.
Wow.
So we're really trying to do our part to create the next generation of scholars, whether it's for Monterey Tech or UNAM or Colegio de Mexico or Harvard or Yale.
Mm-hmm.
So we think that the word we're trying to get out here, and you're helping me on this show, is to say finances will not be an inhibiting factor to come to Yale.
You just got to get in. That's the bottom line.
So study hard, work hard, but apply early.
And get good grades.
Yes, very much so.
Now, is there a website where our listeners could go to if they want more information?
Thank you very much. Yale, Yale, .edu. We'll give you an entire array of our missions aspects, but also our intellectual centers. I'd also like to mention that every one of your listeners can come to Yale at least virtually, because we have full Yale College courses online for free,
mm-hmm.
and they're available for everyone, whether it's the arts and sciences, the social sciences. We have, we think, something for everyone.
That is so cool. That is great. So www.yale.edu, correct?
Yes.
Thank you so much, Linda, and I hope a lot of our listeners will reconsider and start applying. I know it's a long process. I mean, we have to tell people that. It just doesn't happen overnight.
No, you have to start in the fall, and then we give acceptances out just about this time of year. We'll be sending out our acceptances next week.
Thank you so much, Linda.
Thank you so much.
That was Linda Lormer. She is the vice president for Yale University. She's visiting Mexico. Once again, I would suggest check out their website, www.yale.edu. And who knows, maybe you will be the next student going to Yale. Check out the website.